A new U.S. bill could ban the use of console scalper bots. A group of politicians want to take action against the so-called Grinch bots. This is something that should have happened a long time ago, honestly. But I think this time around, it was very apparent, very obvious that the consoles that came out over a year ago, the Xbox Series X and the PS5, were both very hard to obtain. Even the newer version of the Nintendo Switch, the Switch OLED model, was a problematic console to get also, to get a hold of. Even games like Metroid Prime Dread. Now the standalone wasn't too bad, but the special edition was, and it still is, and it's being scalped like crazy. I actually was lucky to be able to get one myself, and I will be doing an unboxing video on that one on my Nintendo Fanboy channel. So, another thing that I'm looking forward to getting, other than the PS5 and the Xbox Series X, is the Xbox Series X mini fridge. That thing is being scalped like crazy as well, and it's a Target exclusive. So, you know, you have customers like myself that are getting mad at Target when really it's not their fault. But I still like to hold retailers accountable for this at some level. I do understand and I don't blame Sony either, and I don't blame Microsoft. It's out of their control once it leaves their warehouses. But I think they're both doing what they can. Sony did the personal invites, and Microsoft is doing that as well now, inviting customers to directly purchase these consoles from them. So I'm going a little off topic here, but let's go ahead and just continue reading here this article I have. The Stopping Grinch Bots Act is being introduced by a group of representatives. And, you know, as we know, bots are, they work automatically by notifying users when there's a item in stock at retailers and before there's any wait times. And so this adds the items to the scalper's carts, and it completes the checkout process way before any other customers are able to do so. And of course, it's nothing new. This has been going on for a while. Like I stated in the past, tickets have been a target, has been an issue with scalping in the past with bots. It's hoped that this new bill will be signed into law, as was the Better Online Ticket Sales Act, which was introduced by Tonko Blumenthal, if that's how you say name. I just butchered that name. Back in 2016, to make it illegal to use bots to buy event tickets. If the new law passed, it would apply to a similar ban to online retail sites, making it illegal to use bots to buy stock as soon as it's made available. At a time when families should be able to spend time with their loved ones, digital Grinch bots are forcing Americans to scour online sites in the hopes of finding an affordable gift or paying high prices for a single toy. Now, it really does suck. I mean, I can tell you my own personal experience why I don't have the two newer consoles is because I'm not gonna overpay, and I'm not gonna support the scalpers, and I'm not gonna pay more than retail. I understand that not everybody has a PC. And, you know, if I want to play some high-end games, I do have a PC for that. The PS4 and the PC is just fine for me right now. But I do want to get me a Series X. And I saw a Series S the other day at the store, and I kind of want to pick that up as well. I think I might eventually. The price is right, and then I can just store all my digital games there. I'm more of a physical game, but games like Apex Legends that and just some other games that are only available digitally, it'll work fine for a console like that, so I don't mind that. But yeah, I really hope they enforce this law, but I think this enough is enough. It's we work hard for our money and we deserve fair prices, especially with the way everything is right now. There's so much going on in this world and every little thing. I'm just gonna rant now. You guys are gonna hear me rant. Gas prices have gone up. Houses, the housing costs have gone up. The cost of living overall has gone up. Even our gaming consoles have gone up in prices. Our graphics cards for PCs have gone up. Everything is going up. I even got a notice the other day. I'm not even joking. If I remember, I'll post a little picture here. I got a notice telling me that my rent is going up. And as you guys know, some of you might know, I mentioned in the past that I'm going to be moving soon. And that's a big factor. That's a big reason why, too. We were told in the past that our rent would be increasing, and now we got the actual paperwork. So now it's set. So I don't want to continue renting. I just want to buy a house, but the house market is ridiculous as well. That's a whole nother headache and process. So yeah, that's just a little bit of that. Just everything is up, so much more expensive, and it's ridiculous. At least this right here will help us gamers. I can go on with this topic. I don't know if I should or not because I know this video will be long, but long story short, the reason why you don't see so many exclusives to both the PS5 and the Xbox Series X like you have in the past, by this time when the PS4 and Xbox One released, they already had their own games that weren't even available for PS3. That's a PS4 exclusive and so on and so on. But the market on the PS4 is so huge right now and not so many people have the PS5. It doesn't make sense to really give it that, to do that. So that's why they do cross games now. And it's ridiculous. It really is. So I ranted a lot more on this video than I wanted to, but I did want to share that with you guys. A new US bill could ban the use of console scalper bots. Let me know what you guys think about this. Is it about time? Do you care? Way to ruin someone's hustle. I mean, some of you guys probably don't even care about scalpers, or you guys are all about making money or whatever. I can go into all that on a separate video. There is so much I gotta say on this topic, but for now, that's all I gotta say is I think we're getting closer to finally making things right here when it comes to this overpriced gaming machines and accessories and stuff. So, Dark Flame out. I'll catch you guys on the next one. As always, game on.